Hello from Antelope Audio HQ. We'll be demonstrating our latest and greatest feature today, the long-awaited Windows Thunderbolt Driver. For now, it only supports ASIO, but it's stable and fast. We're using the Orion Studio with the latest firmware version and the latest version of the Thunderbolt Driver. We'll be using ASIO to do a multi-channel loopback recording. For that, in the Orion Studio control panel, we're routing all Thunderbolt playback channels to Thunderbolt Record. We also want to hear the mix of the channels, so we'll route them also to the first mixer. And then we'll route the first mixer to headphones, monitor, and SPDIF. We'll be using Studio One version 3 on an Intel Core i7 CPU at 3.7 GHz. Although the driver is not CPU intensive, higher CPU frequencies help to lower the latency. We've loaded a song with 6 stereo tracks that we'll play back and record. We're recording at 192 kHz. Each audio track will be played on a separate channel, and we'll record back from the corresponding record channels from the device. You can see on the screen what the routing in Studio One looks like in the console. Then, we'll set up our driver's buffer size. The smaller the buffer, the lower the latency. The default values are selected to be stable in large sessions with lots of plugins. However, since we'll be doing loopback recording, we can lower the buffer size to 48 samples. We'll also use the advanced settings to tweak the playback and record safety offsets. These allow for some headroom for the driver and the DAW when there are CPU spikes. The smaller the offsets, the lower the latency. As you can see, we can achieve sub-millisecond latency this way. Note that this is digital-only latency. ADDA is not included. Now we're ready to start. Enjoy the song. Look. Okay, we're done recording. We hope you like the song. Now, let's play it back to hear that there are no glitches. Thank you for listening and happy thunderbolting with your Antelope device.